Hey YouTube, it's Krista Nicole, and I'm back with another video. Today I'm gonna do a kind of like a get ready with me, my everyday makeup look. It is Friday, so I'm kind of just in a good mood, so I thought that I would film another video. And also, I'm filming on my iPad, but I'm filming in a different area. There is a mirror right behind here, so hopefully, like, instead of looking like over here, I can look straight ahead and then look right into the mirror. So hopefully it looks like I'm kind of looking at you guys. So yeah, this might be chatty, but I'm gonna try to do it quickly, in hopes that it won't be too long, because then it'll take like forever to upload. So I have my little snacks. I have some Lifesavers and Skittles in here while I do my makeup. And I have like all of my makeup spread out on the counter. So I'm gonna be like grabbing whatever I need. Also, let me see what else I have to say. Nothing. So let's just go ahead and get started. And first I'm gonna start with a primer. And for a long time I didn't use a primer, then whenever I did start using a primer, I got the wrong one, so I hated it, so I went back to not using it. And then I got this one, which is a mineral-infused face primer by e.l.f., which is one of my favorite brands. And I usually just take like a pump and a half or two. Two is kind of too much, but a pump and a half is fine. And I have literally lights everywhere in here, so there's one here, there's two here, one up there, one back here, the sunlight. So I hope that the video is at least a little bit clear, because I don't have a lighting system yet, so until I get one of those. We're gonna have to be doing whatever works. So I have my primer on, and it might look shiny, because I mean all this reflection is like gonna make me look shiny. So then I'm gonna take my blending sponge or beauty blender, and someone's calling me. Ignore, nobody important. So bam, shake it up. And then I love this one. It's the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Foundation, because it goes on somewhat like dewy and then it dries matte, which I've never had, so it's like my new favorite. And it comes with a little spatula like this, if you can see it. And so I just take some, and sometimes I'll put it like right on my beauty blender, and then sometimes I'll dab it on my face. So, like so. Do you hear that? It's like the loudest point ever. I don't know if you can hear that yet though. Okay, so then, oh, it looks like I'm going to war. Okay, so let's see how this looks. I should put some music on, but like for the background, but I don't know like too much about the YouTube world and like how music and copyrights work, so scratch that. Right now I look like a fucking maniac, but I have like super shiny, but it's going to dry matte, so I'm not that worried about it. Anyways, about the music, I don't know like what I'm like completely allowed to play in the background of my videos, like actual music wise and I don't want to get in trouble. Like, I just started this channel, I don't want to be in trouble already. So I don't know if I should play some like, what is it called? Some non-copyrighted music, which I won't get in trouble for. But it's kind of boring and it's only like, it has no words. I haven't found a good website for it yet. So, okay, like second of all, I need to put some clear lip gloss on my lips because they're looking ratchet. And the foundation like blends in, so that's just to keep them moisturized while I do my makeup. So I think this might be good for foundation. I didn't really want to go heavy, which is very buildable, which I like, and it's thin, so like you just saw me just now and it looked like I put a lot, but it's really thin and you can kind of still see like through, so that's what I like, because it's buildable. And it's, especially in the summer, like I get hot really easily, and a lot of the times I don't like to put makeup on because it's really thick. So this one has been like, I've been loving it through summer, so I'm excited that I found it. It probably found me, but whatever, we'll say that I found it. Okay, and so usually I'll go in with concealer next, and I have two. This one's the Wet n Wild concealer corrector, photo focus, which I guess kind of goes with this because it's also photo focus. And then I have this e.l.f., it's super dirty right now, but I have this e.l.f. Lightweight concealer stick. It's corrector, but I don't know if I said in one of my other videos, I don't really correct anything, I just kind of like to brighten up my under eyes and my t-zone, so we'll go with that. Yeah, so I don't know, it's kind of quiet like in the background. Maybe next time I'll have some music. And then I'll just blend, 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 blend. I like to use this side for the blending and this side for like my foundation. So I'm really glad that I got a few more subscribers, and I think that's really cool. I wasn't really looking towards, I actually don't know what I'm looking for, like if I wanna, what to do on YouTube. I'm just kind of doing like a mixture of all different kind of things. And hopefully that's fine. I really don't know, it's just that it's kind of fun, so I'm liking it. Which I think is important because I watch a lot of YouTube videos, like vloggers, beauty vloggers, like food specialists, like families, just all like a mixture of all kinds of stuff, cooking, music, covers, so which I really love. Hopefully I can do one day, because I do like to sing. I'm just like pretty shy about it. I'm probably not that good anymore. I mean, I sound super good in my shower, but James doesn't think so, and that's my boyfriend, so just kidding. Actually, he sounds pretty funny in the shower. Sounds really good, actually. He's hilarious. Hopefully I can do a video with him soon. He said he was fine with it, and he's hilarious as well, so I think you guys will really like him. Maybe I can do either like a vlog with him, or we could do like a pranking video. I don't know, I heard those were funny. We like to do music in the car, which I think that we might get copyrighted for, which is why I haven't done it yet. So anyways, next I'm gonna go in with my hair is like all over the place, guys. I didn't even brush it before the videos. Okay, so I just started YouTube and I already have this bad habit of like not getting ready before the video. Like, who starts a video without getting your stuff prepared before? Like my hair, it's always messed up and I'm just like, okay, I thought I was ready for the video, but apparently not. So for my contour, I have this e.l.f. contouring blush and bronzer, and it looks like this. You can see like everything's in there. Ooh. Anyways, it looks like this, and the blush is too light for my skin tone, I feel like, but I feel like the contour is perfect because I don't know if you can see with all this light, but there's like a shadow here, and that's literally natural, like my face naturally contours right there, or I guess my cheekbones are naturally like that, so I don't even have to do contouring if I don't want to, because it'll kind of already look like I do, but I usually just put a tiny bit, and I take this stipple brush by e.l.f., and I just go right in here. Blend it right in. And I have these spots on my face, I don't know if you can tell, but that's just my skin being so freaking annoying. And I just put a tiny bit. I make sure that I blend it, because I've seen some really harsh, like, contouring lines, and I don't know if that's the look that these people were going for, but it's the look that came across whenever you see them, so I just try to blend it, because I don't want mine to look like that. And I like it really lightly, not a big deal. So it just kind of, like, accentuates my cheekbones. This one you can't really see, because the light is literally almost directly on it. So, okay, I use that one. Also, sometimes for my contour, I'll take this baked eyeshadow palette, and it's super old. Like, the packaging is so dirty. And, like, if you look at it, it's, like, beaten up. Like, I wore it down. You can see that, you can see which ones I love, obviously. And I'll usually take this shade for my contour very lightly. Next, I'm going to do blush, and I'm super sad to tell you this, guys. Look how horrible this is. I just got this blush, like, not even two weeks ago. And it's already crumpled. I dropped it on the ground. So I usually take this blush brush by e.l.f. And now I just kind of have to, like, be careful where I dab it. And then I'll just take a little. It's, like, my all-time favorite color, my everyday favorite color. Once in a while, I'll go, like, a more pinky tone. But I like this one. It's kind of like a deep orange tone. I don't know if you can really see it on camera. But I love it, and I just take it literally all around, and even up sometimes. I feel like that makes it like a more natural look. I should have went like with pinky, because my shirt is actually baby pink. Probably would look really cute. Okay. So I got my blush on. And there is like actually one thing that I didn't do, which was use my under eye setting powder for my eyes. So I think I'm going to do that. But I'm going to add like this lightning concealer just right there. So it'll stay. And also, I really love this. Like, if I don't use this, my concealer under my eyes is creasing so bad. My cousin's like, you need a little do a little dab and wipe there. But whenever I do use the under eye setting powder, it works so good. And it works for hours. So, like, I can go literally, like, all about my business all day and not have, like, a crease under my eye. So, like, for my concealer. So I think that is super cool. And I got it a very long time ago, and I've been using it up, so. And it just comes in like the tiniest pot, like this. It has like some translucent powder. And I'll take my, it's a contour brush by Real Techniques. So I'll just dab it in there like very lightly and just swoop it under there like in this motion. Also like during the rest of the day, I can really tell because I don't put this all over my face. I can really tell where my makeup stays, which is in my T-zone area, because that's where I put it. So I've even thought about just going and trying to find an actual, like, big translucent powder for my whole face. And I haven't got one yet. I think e.l.f. does, like, an HD one, but I'm not sure. I need to go get one, because I think that it would help my makeup stay, like, all day. So anyways, so I did contour, I did blush, and the next is highlight. So I have been loving this Wet n Wild Illuminating Palette, and this one's fairly new. But I have been wearing it every day since I got it. Now, before, I used to just wear, it's an eyeshadow, which I don't know if you guys think that's weird or not, but I used this shade, and I don't really know if you can tell what shade it is, but I thought it looked really good, so I can show you maybe, like, the way that one looks. I don't know if it'll be, like, comparable or not, or if you'd even be able to see it, but you can kind of see what goes on there. And then this one's gonna be on the other side, but I just used this. It's also a contour brush, but I use it for highlight, and so I've been taking, like, whatever shade I want, actually. I'm not sure if you can see that. And then I'll just, like, kind of blend it out here. I love it because I have this light up here and you can really, like, see this. So, yeah, and I'll just take it, like, here. And also, I like to take a brush like this. And it was either this one or the one that I had in my eyeshadow palette. And I'll just take a dab and then just swoop it right across the middle. Right up here. Right in this zone. I love the way it looks in, like, selfies and stuff whenever you have this highlighted. But I've seen people do it to, like, the extreme. And it's, like, sometimes it looks good and sometimes it doesn't. So I try to be careful because I don't want to be one of those ones who do, like, too much and then it just looks crazy. So I'll take a little bit more of this shade and I'll put it, like, right on my Cupid's bow. I don't know if you can see that. You probably can. And then I'll just blend. Blend it out a little bit. I think it looks fine and it's not really picking up in the camera, but I can see clearly in the mirror, like, straight ahead of me, so I like the way that came out. Next, we're gonna move on to, oh, I feel like I got something there on my nose. Next, we're gonna move on to, I guess, eyeliner, because it's just plain. It's just a plain Wet n Wild black eyeliner pencil. And so I'm just gonna take that right in my waterline. I went a very long time just wearing eyeliner, like, whenever I started my makeup out. I was, like, in middle school, and I only wore eyeliner. So, like, I didn't know a thing about makeup, and eyeliner was, like, if I didn't have it, I could not go to school. I felt like it was, like, something that I had to have every day. And then I went for a couple of years not wearing it at all, which was kind of surprising because it was, like, such a staple of mine. But yeah, but now, like, I've been loving it again, and I've been wearing it every single day. So there was a time period where this, like, little bit of hair is, like, getting on my nerves. So I have such baby hairs right here that I have to try to hide them, and it's hard because they just want to come out. I love them, though. Sometimes they, like, give me a cute. Sometimes they work with me. Most times they don't, but, you know, I love them for the times that they do try to work with me. Anyway, so we did eyeliner. And then I hate eyebrows, so I mentioned that in one of my other videos, and I hate everything that has to do with an eyebrow. Because mine are so weird, I need to pluck, like, just the edges, because honestly, I don't know what to do with them. Like, one day I just need to go into, like, a beauty store and get them done. Like, see if someone can do something about these, like, horrendous caterpillars on my face. Who else doesn't like eyebrows? Like, you know what? Actually, I feel like a lot of people are into them right now. Not I. I am not with the eyebrow trend. I need to get with the trend. Get with the program, Kristen. Okay, anyway, so next about eyebrows, I use this pencil and literally lifesaver. Also, this one I've been loving, which is the brow tint. So, sometimes I'm gonna do it here because I cannot see. I'll just lightly try to fill in where, like, there's no hair, obviously. It's so annoying, but I have, like, patches. I don't know if you can really see the difference, but I'll just go in and fill it. I don't want them to be dramatic, and sometimes I do it on accident because I get so frustrated that I'm just, like, coloring it in and it just never ends. So, and I'll just try to do that. See, like, I'm so weird and I hate them. So just, like, ignore my eyebrows. Like, that's really hard to do because every time I, like, talk to somebody, I feel like I stare at their eyebrows. And I think I do it because I don't want them to stare at mine, so then I think about it too much, so I'm really annoying. I annoy myself, actually. So, like, look what I just did. I just, like, messed it up from being so annoying. Anyways, I'm about to get over this. Okay, so then I'll take, like, the treat. And it looks like a little gel that I'll put on there to just kind of, like, I feel like it'll darken it up. And this one's a brush, so this is why I like this, actually. Because of this cute little brush right here. It looks like a mascara brush. And then it just, like, creates, like a combed look, a wet comb look. And I kind of really like that. And I don't want to say that I'm getting into eyebrows. Look at this. Can you even see that? Like, now I need to do something about it. Hold on. I'm trying to fix it. Yeah, okay. So, screw those eyebrows. Like, I hate them. Whatever, nobody cares. I'm going to just go ahead and do my eyes, and then that's basically almost it. So, for every day, I literally do the same exact thing, and it's put in all over color, like, all over lid color. And I kind of just do whatever I want. I don't go by any trends because I'm not that good at doing makeup. I just feel like I do my own makeup the way I like it. So, literally, I'm going to take, like, this palette and this palette. I've been using these two, like, back-to-back nonstop. So, I'm just going to take some all over, like, shimmery base shade. Also highlight the brow. The brow bone. Even though I don't want to be highlighting the brows because I hate the brows. Hate them. Okay, so I'm gonna do that. So I just take it all over, kind of highlight it, because usually it gets covered up anyways, but I like a base. Then I will go in with the, I already know that I put a brown, darker brown shade in the crease of my eye towards the outer edge. That's just my favorite. So usually next I'll go in with the color that I want to stand out. And I've been loving these two recently, which is the this one. And you can't see like the tone so good, and this one. Because I'm like more neutrally, I wonder if you can see it like this way. No, probably not. Anyway, so I'm gonna take my, no, I feel like I lost the brush. I did, and it's the one where I blend out in the corner, but I do have this one, which is the one I just take all over with the color that I want. So I'm gonna do that now, and I'm gonna go ahead and go in with the darker shade, which is this one. And they don't have names, but they are in the e.l.f. Prism Shadow Palette, which I am so glad that I found. And I think that I found it in Burlington Coat Factory in Odessa, which is where I went with my boyfriend like a week or two ago. So I'm taking this color literally all over my lid because it's so pretty. It's like a champagne-y color, and you probably cannot see it at all, which is so annoying. Well, I can't wait to get like a lighting system so you can see it very clear. So just taking that all over. And I just put like however much I want. Then I'm gonna go in with this other color that I'm using. And I'm gonna go towards like the inner half of my lid, my eyelid. I don't know if like if it's focusing. Maybe, maybe not. I don't know if you can see. Probably not, but I feel like I can see so clearly, and it's just not like coming out how I want it. Anyway, so it looks so good right now, or I feel like it does. And then I'm gonna take, just with my finger because I don't have my brush, I'm gonna take this one, which is like my super fave. Obviously you can see I hit pan. And I'm just gonna take my finger in there, and I'm gonna do it like around the corners on my own. Because I don't have my brush, so I'm just gonna do this, and then I'll blend it out. And I just take that at the corner. I feel like it adds some depth and some like definition to my eyes. Because I don't do too much with them, I feel like it's perfect for me. Like it's right like where I need it to be. I like it. And for every day, like seriously, every day that I feel like putting makeup on, this is kind of what I do. So I'm just gonna take this and I'm gonna blend it out like the edges. And it's already like pretty blended, so that's why I really like this palette. The colors work really well together, obviously. That's why they put them together. And then if you have like excess eyeshadow that's fallen, I just take a brush and I swoop it off, and that usually does the trick. So I'm kind of really liking that. So I guess like I only have two things left, which is she's like watching me back there. She's standing back there. That's Mickey. She's been kind of sick, so she's been in bed, and I've been she's been watching Charlie Brown, The Peanuts Movie. That's her favorite on her iPad, and that's what she loves. So she's back there doing that. Right now she's watching me. She loves the camera. So okay, so next I only have two things left, which is the mascara and I guess lips. I guess I'm gonna try to do the color. Let's go ahead and do mascara and get it over with, because seriously. And also this one is not my everyday. I forgot to mention that. This is the only one that I got today though in my bag. And I don't really know why I don't have the other ones. I'm just gonna use this mirror ahead of me and this mirror here to get the these looking a little more voluminous. I think that's what it's called. Where it has volume, voluminous. I've heard that like on a mascara commercial before, so maybe not this one. This one is the Lash Blast Volume Waterproof. So, oh my goodness, I did not know this was waterproof. I had been trying to take it off for a very long time last night and it would not budge. So, there I go, smart one. It's freaking waterproof and I couldn't take it off in the shower. What an idiot. I was trying hard and I feel like I rubbed my eye and it hurt, like my eyes were hurting. What an idiot. I did not even read the packaging because I used to get these orange ones all the time. I just didn't know that this one was the waterproof one. I think that's gonna be fine for now. I need an eyelash curler. I've never used one, and I heard they work really well. So I need to get one of those. So I'm just gonna do a few strokes on the bottom lashes. Also, I wanna start wearing false eyelashes every once in a while. I think they look really nice if you know how to put them on, but I don't know how to put them on, so they kind of just look like, oh my god, what the hell are you wearing? And I really don't want that, so I don't want anybody to say that about me. So, that's basically my makeup look and routine. I kind of do that all the time. My last thing that I usually do is I spray it with the Makeup Mist and Set by e.l.f. and I just kind of do it all over. And Nikki is just like seriously just watching me. So sorry guys, she's in my video. I'm just going to take it all over. I'm gonna do about like a few sprays. Oh my god, that just got in my mouth. What an idiot. I usually don't talk after I do that, but I did, so. And then it'll just dry, like semi-matte, which is like my fave. So then I dry. Ooh, I haven't even been eating like my candy. So I'm drying. And then I'll put some more lip gloss on. For almost every day, I don't wear this lipstick. This is the only one I have. Actually, it's a butter gloss. So I guess that's it, because I really don't feel like putting that one on right now. It's kind of heavy on my lips. I hope that you guys enjoyed that talkative, unprofessional, non-makeup artist makeup look. Everyday makeup look. So yeah, I hope that I can maybe upload another vlog this weekend. I don't know what I'll be up to. Probably nothing. My boyfriend works all weekend, so I'm kind of sad about that, but we'll see. Just stay tuned and be subscribed with me. And I want to do a giveaway, but I want to wait till I have a little bit more subscribers. So if you're watching this and you're interested in maybe like stationery, makeup bits, just anything actually. I like a lot of stuff, so I feel like if I do a giveaway, it'd be like a mixture of a whole bunch of things. So if you want to enter a giveaway coming up, please subscribe, like the video, comment, stay good with me, and you can be entered for a chance to win in one of my giveaways soon. So anyways, yep, this is the finished look, and my everyday makeup is basically the same all the time. I'll change like maybe two browns. Add a little bit of pink in there, change up my blush every once in a while, but basically it stays the same, and I really want to get away from that, so hopefully maybe my next makeup video will be like new stuff that I haven't tried before, like a first impression, so I think that might be cool. So anyways, give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and thank you for watching. Please subscribe!